Hey everyone, back at you again with another movie review, and today it's a little bit of an atypical movie review, but obviously something that is so huge in the cultural zeitgeist that I had to talk about it on here, and that of course is Taylor Swift The Eras Tour, directed by Sam Wrench, following Taylor Swift's three-night stint at the SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California, which, of course, was filmed over the period of those 3 days and literally cut together in less than 2 months because this was took place in August, and it's already out in theaters. And first off, I have to say, the thing that always amazes me about Taylor Swift, because I am quite a fan of Taylor Swift and her music overall, and one thing that amazes me outside of that is her ability to just create these amazing business decisions that really kind of transform the landscape of what you can do in the industry, and honestly having a lot of people pissing in their pants at the same time. Because look, this is completely unprecedented, where she essentially bypassed the studio system, went straight to theaters for distribution. Like, that is huge. And even if you aren't a fan of Taylor Swift or her music, like, that cannot be understated how impactful that is. How big of a deal that is going forward. I mean, obviously, Taylor Swift has a lot more money than most people, right? But even so, the precedent has now been set for this playing field that anyone can kind of jump into now and at least try for it, because this is going to be... I'd like to think this is going to be huge for the movie industry going forward, for filmmakers in general, and I think that's a huge deal, and I respect the hell out of Taylor as a businesswoman more than anything, because she's really been able to make some very groundbreaking decisions, and I figured I would get that right out of the way before I actually talked about the concert, because look, I was stupid, and I didn't realize that this was literally every single album, even though it's called Eras Tour, right, go figure. You know, because I'll be honest, I mean, I didn't review it because I didn't want to come on here and bash Taylor Swift, but I thought Midnights was not a good album, and I wasn't really wanting to see her on this particular tour. And the whole thing with Ticketmaster charging $500 to see her in general, like, I wasn't in the market for that. You know, I was trying to get tickets to Bruce Springsteen, and I didn't spend $500 on that, thankfully, and still waiting on that concert. But regardless, I was intrigued once I heard what the concept of the show was, and the fact it was coming to theaters. So, 'cause look, I mean, if you're going into this as $20 for a Taylor Swift concert, okay, by all means, you should absolutely go see it. If you're looking at this from a movie standpoint, like, I'm going to go see a movie for $20, yeah, your mileage may vary, especially if you aren't a fan of Taylor Swift, then just don't go see it. That would be my recommendation right off the bat, because this is almost 3 hours long, 3 hours worth of Taylor Swift material, which overall I was quite pleased by. You know, like, let me put it to you this way. I think Taylor Swift, at her best, is an exceptional songwriter, absolutely brilliant storyteller, and I think, at her worst, she makes some of the most generic pop music out there. So, I'm really only in love with about two-thirds of her discography. The rest of it, I think you can kind of take it or leave it. And of course, there's some gray area there, because there's some stuff I really like, but I don't fully love the albums from those specific eras. But regardless, I really wanted to see the show and how she presented these, you know, different eras to the audience, and just the performance itself and the stagecraft. And I was impressed on all fronts, I must say. Look, I mean, Taylor as a performer is such a professional. She's got charisma, she's got the talent, she's got sex appeal, I mean, literally everything, but really above all else, the talent that this woman has is just amazing. Like I said, the stage presence, everything about this show is really undeniable, even if you aren't a fan of Taylor Swift. I mean, try putting a show like this together. Yeah, I dare you to. But still, I absolutely love what she did and her team going into the show. Because even, like, songs I'm not huge on, like when you start off with Lover, the Lover section, and you got to I'm the Man, which I'm really not a huge fan of the writing in that song. I think she's dealt with issues like that in more constructive and brilliant ways, like The Last Great American Dynasty, which the performance in this was just killer when we got to the folklore era. But even so, I think the visual component of watching that song really made me appreciate it a lot more. And I think I felt that way about a lot of the performances in this particular show. But for me, it was really, once you got to that middle section with Red going right into folklore and right through the beginning of 1989 with Blank Space and Style. I think the order was switched there. But regardless, that was the part I was really, really into, especially the performances during the Red era are just unbelievably bombastic, energetic, full of life. And just that, oh my goodness, the beautiful moment between her and Bianca Bryant when she goes up and hugs her was just so heartwarming. I wanted to tear up watching that scene, and it was just so beautiful seeing the interactions on stage and otherwise. I just think the energy was really unbridled in the best way possible during those segments, because even like the Fearless stuff, I mean, I love those songs that they performed, but I wasn't as much into the energy of the concert, you could say. And even like albums that I don't like Reputation, I really enjoyed the editing and the cinematography. The way this was cut together by Sam Wrench and company has to be commended, because it is insanely good. And for someone who doesn't even like those songs to be really invested in that section was really something impressive. Though I did have to go to the bathroom for Don't Blame Me, so I missed that number. But besides that, you know, I was really, really impressed by the technical aspect of this concert all the way through. Sure, it isn't going to be as mind-blowing as Stop Making Sense, we'll say, but regardless, I absolutely love what they did. And I think from a budgetary standpoint, it was much bigger than Stop Making Sense with the stage craft that they had on display in this film. But back to the standout numbers for me, of course, yeah, I was talking about the entirety of the Red tour, but especially 22 and the performance of her 10-minute masterpiece, All Too Well, was just absolutely breathtaking. As simplistic as the camera techniques and everything was, it was done in such a way that felt so digestible, and I just felt entranced by that song. And it also helps that you have basically her two best songs almost back to back. I mean, there's a song in between, but once you get to Betty as well, I just love the whole folklore setup with the cabin. It was really, really great, and I was just in awe of that whole section of the movie. And of course, I have to mention Blank Space, which was another absolute standout, easily my favorite song off of the 1989 album. And that was the thing. That was when the movie started dipping me. Because, as I said, when you get to generic pop music with Taylor Swift, I think 1989 is when it really starts. And so after that point, I wasn't as into it as much. I mean, I still was enjoying it. But really, to me, as I said with Midnights, I kind of really don't like that album at all. And so the fact that that is probably the biggest and most prominent era on this tour really will indicate how much my mileage varied on this concert. And of course, I mean, that's only natural. It's her last album. It's the cycle. You gotta, you know, play the hits, play the new songs, you know, all that sort of thing. But yet again, I mean, I found myself appreciating the performances of the said songs, but I wasn't really into it at that point. Though I will say, even though I'm not a fan of the song, the performance of Vigilante Shit was incredible. Once again, it's really what they did on stage and how her dancers interact with her and how the stage moves them up and down, and it's just so beyond compelling to watch, and just the dancing alone, and really maybe the sexiest number in the whole show, I would say. So I was impressed from that standpoint, but yet again, it's one of those things where I'm really harsh on concert movies in general, because I have to be captivated the whole damn time with every song. Stop Making Sense, if you remember from my review, isn't even quite a 10 out of 10, because there's, you know, a couple songs that maybe I'm not as huge on, and maybe that's a personal thing I'll fully admit that. But it definitely affects your enjoyment of the show overall. But yet again, the fact that she was able to reel me in for almost 3 hours, you do feel the length. Like, this isn't... Look, I'll put it this way. This is very impressive, but it isn't the next best thing since sliced bread or anything like that. And I certainly, for my own personal prerogative, would not pay $500 to see the show. But the fact that it was released and that we got to see it was really, I couldn't have been more delighted in that sense. And I really appreciate, yeah, she's making a ton of money off of it, but I appreciate the fact that she gave the fans the opportunity and made so many mind-blowing business decisions in doing so, because this is going to be huge. A huge, huge cultural event. And if you're a Taylor Swift fan, what are you doing? You have to go see this. As I said, you know, depending on how much you love her music and what eras you do love, your mileage, it's going to differ from person to person. I personally wasn't blown away the entire time, but I appreciated the experience overall, and I'm really glad I got to see it. So on that note, I'm going to give Taylor Swift, the Eras Tour, a 7 out of 10. Really, yes, as I said, if you're a fan, go see it. If not, then don't. Basically, that's the review. And yeah, let me know if you guys saw the Eras Tour, if you saw it in theaters, if you saw it in person. Would love to know what you thought about the show in general. And of course, smash the like button, subscribe to the channel. Going to be bringing you a lot more movie reviews, especially this week, because my goodness, I could not be more ecstatic that we are finally getting the next Martin Scorsese film, Killers of the Flower Moon. My goodness, there is not a movie for the rest of the year that I am more excited about than Marty's new picture. So please stay on the lookout for that the end of the week or the very beginning of next. And until then, I will see you guys later.